My father came to me and said, would you like to play soundcheck at Nebworth? And I was 13 and I said, when is it? He said, it's on a Wednesday. I went, sorry Dad, that's a school day. You know, school's more important than Led Zeppelin, sorry. Of course, I was like, what are we going to tell Mom? He goes, you know, do that fake stomach ache in the morning thing. You want me to lie to my mother? Yes. So that Wednesday came along and of course, oh Mom, and then by noon I was fine and I got in the car. And I suddenly realized my dad had just bought a brand new red 928 Porsche. Yeah, rock and roll drummer, fast car, not a good mix. 13-year-old kid, faster, faster, faster. So it was about a 2-hour journey and I'd made a mixtape, so I'm thinking I'm gonna turn my dad onto some of the things that I like. Basically, it was everything that Stuart Copeland had done. So we got there in about an hour with one ticket. You see, when you get stopped in England, they don't give a shit who you are. It was like, yeah, name, John Bonham. What, like, the drummer? Yes. Never heard of you. It's not like you were in the Beatles, is it, Bingo? And it's Ringo, whatever. So we got there, and he gave me the little heads up, go up there, play. So I'd rehearsed a little. And he just said, remember this, Jimmy Page will extend the guitar solo, so wait for him to give you the head. I'm like, Dad, I got this, go out front, listen to your drums. So I sat on his drum kit, and it felt huge. And it sounded huge. His monitors were about as far away as the other side of the stage, like its own PA. And it was like heaven. I was like sat there like a cat does when it needs the thing. It's like, oh shit, this is so good. It really was. It was like the drug that gave me to start playing. And my dad went out front, and the guy came up to him and said, who's playing drums? He said, that's my son, Jason. Yeah. And he goes, what do you think? He goes, well, I'll tell you this is the first time I've ever seen Led Zeppelin play live. It's a true story. So that evening, or that weekend, when I got to see my dad play in front of 200,000 people, suddenly, you know what? Maybe he was better than Stuart Copeland after all. And this one particular song has stuck with me ever since he's been gone. And it's one of my favorites, and hopefully be yours. With a little help from my friend, Mr. Jimmy Sakurai, I want to take you back to that August night that blew my mind.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.